Hello, welcome back. I'll tell you what, I've had an incredible week since last week. I videoed last week on Wednesday, and today's Wednesday, and my life has just been very interesting. Incredible. Now, I'm 64 years old, and I've put a lot of effort into getting to where I'm at today. You don't have to wait 60-something years to get to a life that you really want to have. Here's a question. What would make your best day ever? Get a piece of paper and a pen and write down what would happen on your best day ever. It's going to be different for everybody. You know, for some of us, it might be spending time with your family. For some of us, it might be traveling. It could be to finish a marathon. What would make it the best day of your life? And so, several years ago, I sat down with a piece of paper and a pen, and I wrote out what I think my best day ever would be. And it involved a few different things, activities that I like to do, and I got all of those activities in one single day. Now, there's a lot of activities I didn't get crammed into that day, but I will tell you, I started out early in the morning, about 5 o'clock in the morning, woke up next to my beautiful wife. That was something I always wanted, to have a beautiful wife, a wife that I loved and she loved me, and we could have a family. And down the hall were my kids that were sleeping, and I got up and I went down, I got a cup of coffee, and after I got my coffee, I went out to Lake Hefner and I ran 9.2 miles with my friends. And afterwards, I came home, took a quick shower, and drove out to the General Aviation Airport. And some of my other friends met me there, and I had chartered a small plane, twin-engine plane, that would hold, I think, 6 or 8 people on it. And we loaded up on the plane, and we flew to Angel Fire, New Mexico. It took about an hour and a half to get there, hour and 15 minutes. And the shuttle picked us up at the airport and took us to the ski slope. We skied all day long, had a great time. The snow was great, the sky was perfect. Came home, flew home that after we skied all day, had dinner with my family. There were a few things that I didn't mention that I did in that day, but those are between me and my wife. So we had a great time. It was a fantastic day. But what would make your life, what would be the best day you've ever had? So I recommend you write it down and see if you can make that happen in your life. Right now, you can fly to Dubai from Dallas, Texas for less than $1,000 round trip. If you're a smoker and you stop smoking for, 3 or 4 months, you'd have $1,000 to be able to fly to Dubai. And you can stay in a hotel for less than $300 a day, which is a lot of money. But if you go with some friends, say 3 other friends, and you divide that by 4, it gets to be a reasonable price for a hotel. We can do so much more in life than we do today if we just figure out what we want and we're willing to take the action and learn how to be able to do it. Now, I want to be brief about what has happened in the last week. One of the things I did is I went with a friend of mine up to the vacation house in the Branson area. We spent a couple of days. We rode sea-doos. We rode motorcycles. We ate fine food. We met not expensive food, just good food, good Mexican food. And then we met some new friends. A 5-hour trip in the car up there, a 5-hour trip on the way back. We talked about business, we talked about God, we talked about family. Just an incredible Thursday, Friday, and came back on Saturday. Awesome. And then Saturday night, I got a little bit of sleep, got up Sunday, and went to Faith Church at 122nd and MacArthur. And then after that, I went to the Good Fight Church, where my friend is the pastor right now. And it was great. I didn't stay for the second service because I needed to get home because it was motorcycle time. I bought a Harley Davidson last week. I bought it for really great price, $3,000 for a beautiful Harley Davidson. I've gotten compliments. It's a 2005. I didn't know what size it was. It was just a lot bigger than my Yamaha 250s. I figured it could be a bike that I could do a road trip on. It's called a Harley Sportster. I didn't know anything about it. There's 2 different versions, a smaller engine and a larger. I ended up with the smaller engine, which I guess gets better gas mileage. It would cruise comfortably between 65 and 75 miles an hour. I didn't have any kind of bags, any saddle bags or anything. So the only luggage I took was a razor blade. Because every morning when I wake up, I shave. First thing I do is I shave. And so I left the church, went home, got on the motorcycle, and I didn't know how to check the oil. Thank goodness for YouTube. Not that I checked it right away, I just drove. And it was about to rain, I got ahead of the rain. I drove all the way to Turkey, Texas. Just 10 miles outside of Kitty Quay, Texas, where one of my heroes is from, Jake Merrell.
My name is Jake Merrell. I'm a senior at Turkey Valley, and I live in a town named Kitty Quay with a population of 411.
And Jake Merrell has inspired me to continue to run, and I just got off the phone with Jake. I didn't get to talk to him when I was in Kitty Quay, Texas, but I met his coach that he had in high school. I met his grandfather, who's an incredible person, great work ethic. He owns a grocery store in Kitty Quay, and he also owns a farm and a ranch. And when I walked into the grocery store, Mr. Merrell was operating the saw. He was a butcher. I mean, he was doing butcher work. I mean, he's not a butcher. He's an entrepreneur. He's a hard worker. He's a good down-to-earth guy. And for over an hour, we got to talk, and I learned so much about work ethic and about living in a small town and the virtues of being in a small town. I just really had a great time in Kitty Quay. And Grandpa gave me Jake's phone number. I was able to get on the phone and talk to him today. And what an inspiration. This guy has got, he's polite. He's got a great work ethic. He graduated, some of you are gonna be a little envious of this. He graduated from Baylor University in 2.5 years. And that was during the COVID time. So that's pretty remarkable. Jake's a really hard worker, takes a lot of action. So, well, after I left Kitty Quay and drove down to Midland, Texas, where I saw a friend of mine that I've known for probably 10 or 11 years and his wife, and we sat in a Starbucks and we talked for over 2 hours. It was an incredible trip. Stayed in Kermit, Texas, in a nice hotel in Kermit, Texas. Very busy, lot of oil going on. It's like an oil boom, so to speak, and then wind power. A lot of people are putting up those giant windmills down there. The United States is really doing some great things for us to become more self-sufficient and have many sources of energy. And I'll tell you, you know, in the media we hear so much about how bad everything is. Well, being on my motorcycle, driving around the United States, meeting people, I had a blast. People are friendly, people are nice, people drive new trucks, used trucks. I mean, there's so much prosperity in the United States. There's so many great places to go, and there's so many great books to read. If you haven't read, and I talk about this often, Atomic Habits, a great book to read. I have just absolutely had a blast since Thursday of last week. Of course, I'm back at my office today. You know, I'm the CEO of Pacebutler Corporation. I started this business in 1987 with $62.53. I had an idea, I took action, I stayed committed. And now over 30 years later, we're still in business. Real estate, I just got off the phone with a guy that wanted me to buy a house. He's one of those guys that finds really good deals and then resells them, known as a flipper. And I'd already looked at the house, and he had a price that he wanted to offer me, which was higher than the price I thought the house was worth. But I passed on that house because it was a little bit out of my normal prerequisites for a house. Because I buy houses and hold them. I don't buy houses and sell them. And I pay cash for them, I don't finance them. And when you're paying cash for things, you get a better deal, but you don't pay interest. And the law of compounding is a lot more beneficial if you're buying and holding and keeping them. Now, my real estate is not my primary business. That's not how I make my money the most. Most of the money I make is through Pacebutler, the company that buys used cell phones here in the United States, and we sell them all over the world. Also, the stocks. I've done very, very well in stocks. I learned from Warren Buffett, you buy stocks and you hold them. Only reason to buy a stock is not because what everybody else is talking about. You buy stock in a company that you would like to own the entire company. Like, who wouldn't want to own Coca-Cola? Who wouldn't want to own Home Depot? who wouldn't want to own possibly Uber? And I think Uber's got a really great business model. They're definitely the leaders in rideshare, as far as I know, especially in the United States. And so I do own some Uber. But most of the money that I made from $62.53 when I started Pacebutler in 1987. There is never a money problem. There are only idea problems. You have to have an idea, take action, and stay committed. And in the book, Atomic Habits, James Clear talks about if you want to be successful, you have to be able to endure boredom. Because we, as entrepreneurs, we want something exciting to happen all the time. And sometimes you just have to be okay with just standstill, where it seems like nothing's happening, and then all of a sudden it clicks. So this trip that I took, I drove 830-something miles. I left my motorcycle at the Harley-Davidson store in El Paso. And in a couple of weeks, I'm going to go down and get back on the bike and take another 600, 700, 800-mile ride and leave it at another Harley store and fly home. So I'm going to go all the way from Oklahoma City down to South Texas and all the way down to Miami. Now, I shared that with you, so now I need to do it. It's not just about talk. So if there's a time when I'm in a rainstorm or there's a time when I don't feel I can go down there, I can't leave the business for a while, I'm going to remember that I made a promise to you guys. And I really like talking to you guys. Thanks for calling. I'm not going to mention any names of the people that have called, but I get energized when I get another entrepreneur that like has an idea that's been doing things with their life or is just getting started. You know, it's just so awesome that we can share because the book, one more time, I read a lot, but The Science of Getting Rich. You get rich by the creative way or you get rich by the competitive way. And I want to get richer being creative. I want to be more creative. I want to help more people. I want to do more things that benefit society. Thank you for tuning in. If you'll share and maybe subscribe, that'd be cool. I really appreciate the calls. Like I said, I like talking to people. I like listening and learning from people. So thank you very much. And I hope you have a wonderful day, week, month, year. If you have a great day, you can have a great week. If you have a great week, you can have a great month. If you have a great month, you can have a great year. Have a great year, you can have a great destiny. Thank you.